आरबीआई गवर्नर शक्तिकांत दास का क्वेश्चन सुनो।
ऑफ साइट सुपरविजन बिकॉज ऑल द डेटा इनफ्लो कम्स ऑलमोस्ट ऑन रियल टाइम बेसिस एंड बेस्ड ऑन द डेटा द यूजिंग वेरियस मेथड्स ऑफ डेटा एनालिटिक्स एंड एआई द नंबर्स आर एग्जामिन्ड द नंबर्स आर एनालाइज्ड फॉर द सिस्टम एज ए होल एंड फॉर इंडिविजुअल बैंक्स एंड एनबीएफसीज एंड यू नो द वल्नरेबिलिटी इंडिकेटर्स any signs or signals of weakness are generated and are analyzed by our officers. It is partly technology driven. It is majorly application of mind to try and see where the future challenges could arise, where the future vulnerabilities or where the future risks may come. So therefore, I'm not sure whether it's a part of the, you know, the work of an auditor, but we would expect from the Reserve Bank auditors also to comment on such aspects while signing the balance sheets of banks and non-banks. And I would feel the same would apply to other businesses and companies as well. Now, we have from the Reserve Bank tried to give a lot of encouragement. We expect the audit profession to be absolutely fair and truthful and not to worry about any sort of any possibility of the management of company. Again, I'm not trying to create a friction between you and the company's management, but to give greater confidence to the auditor community, we have now mandated, you would be aware, we have now mandated prior approval of the Reserve Bank. I repeat, it is now mandatory for any bank or NBFC, banks and UCBs, that is any commercial banks or urban cooperative banks, if they are removing a particular auditor, they can do so only with the prior approval of the Reserve Bank of India. Because we don't want the auditors, the audit company, the audit firm, we don't want you to act under any kind of pressure. So that is one major step which we have taken. We are also having these days for the last 3 years or so, structured meetings with the auditors of individual banks. We have also mandated a minimum of two auditors. We have also mandated a minimum of two auditors to audit the banks. Public sector banks always had, you know, multiple auditors, but many private sector banks had just one auditor year after year. So we have now mandated at least two auditors per, for every bank. We have also mandated a total number of audits, bank audits, which an individual audit firm can take, so that it gives greater opportunity to the entire auditor community to do audit of banks, and also to ensure that the same auditor doing large number of banks, you know, if his knowingly or unknowingly, I repeat, knowingly or unknowingly, if he has any inherent bias in his thinking, that also gets eliminated. And we also have done this only to avoid concentration risk of our audit system vis-a-vis the banks. There are several other steps also which we have taken with regard to appointment of auditors, which we have said we are holding structured meetings with the auditors of the banks and the NBFCs wherever we find that the divergences, the great divergence between the auditor's finding, especially with regard to NPA numbers and the number which is arrived at by our supervisors, we have an interaction with the auditors, audit firm, to find out why the auditor firm missed it out. The idea is to take corrective action. The idea is not to be punitive, not to give punishment or any such thing. The idea is to be collaborative and improve the quality of audit. In very extremely rare cases where we have reasons to believe that it was not done properly or it was done, we feel that it was not done correctly, we refer them to the IC.